So far in this series, we have looked at some guides and the information they provide, different ways to view and link resources, and a range of searching techniques. In this video and the next, we're going to look at several tools to see how they can provide other ways to find the information you want. To open the Bible Browser tool, click Tools and select the Bible Browser. Please note that this requires an internet connection to work. This tool provides the ability to drill down through multiple selection levels using a technique known as faceted browsing, with each of the items on the left being the facets. Expand one, such as people, by clicking the arrow to see the different groups of information in the Bible, nearly 12,000 referring to God, and so forth. In this series, we've been looking at Jesus promising the Spirit to those who are thirsty, to those who believe in Him in John 7, so we're going to browse information about Jesus using figurative language to refer to the Spirit. To find all facets relating to Jesus, type Jesus into the Find box and select the Jesus facet under the People category. This shows all verses tagged as referring to Jesus. Open the figurative language facet and then target and expand the list to see the entry for the Holy Spirit. Add this to the set of filters to constrain the results to just those verses referring to both Jesus and figurative language with the Spirit as the target. Open the intertext facet and then relationship. This shows there are 8 allusions and 3 echoes. Click allusion to constrain the results even further. Now, these relevant verses identified can be saved in a passage list for future reference. To do this, click the panel icon and then Save as Passage List. To find this document for subsequent study, go into the Docs menu and open the recently created Passage List. Sometimes it is useful to display this information at a verse level, as now, but sometimes it is useful to get a wider perspective. To do this, click on Verse at the top and select Pericope. To clear individual facets, simply click the small X before it, and to clear all facets, click Start. Before finishing this video, why not spend some time seeing the range of filters available and exploring different facets you may be interested in? The Bible Browser is very helpful when you are interested in particular categories of information and want to see where they appear, typically in combination with other categories, throughout the Bible. The next video will look at the Concordance tool and will show some of the different ways it allows the content of Bibles and other resources to be analyzed.